Hello, YouTube family, and welcome to another episode of This and That. Yes, it is your boy Rosie, your soon-to-be number one YouTube host. As y'all know, I'm a big fan of the George Foreman grill. I have the George Foreman rotisserie grill outside, and thanks to my sister-in-law lending me the George Foreman indoor-outdoor grill, we're going to be using one of those today. Back in 1994, a gentleman by the name of Michael Bowman invented the George Foreman grill, and they soon after that, they brought George Foreman on, and they created four different series of grills, one of them being the indoor-outdoor grill, and that's what we're going to be using today. Now, the George Foreman indoor-outdoor grill is real easy to put together. You got your pole, you got your base right down here, and you got your grill top. We're going to take the grill top, we're going to put the pole in, and you can see right here, it has that little lip right here. You're going to take this pole, you're going to put this in the lip. Thank you, Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald's helping us this morning. You take this clip, clip it in, simply take your grill, slip it in the base, and you're ready to barbecue. Now, this is an electric grill. So we take our electric plug, we stick it in the side, we plug it up. And we turn it on right here. Now, this thing has five different settings. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. At 5, this thing runs at about 400 degrees. 400 degrees is about the temperature that you want to sear a steak at. And today we're going to be searing the steak, and I'm going to show you a little trick just in case you don't have a controlled temperature that you can take it and you can, after you finish searing your steak, you can use this trick in order to take it off of direct heat. So with that being said, let's get started. So this thing is already coming up to temperature. I can feel the heat already. All right, while we're waiting on that, we're gonna go ahead and season our steak real quick. And y'all know my go-to seasoning. Simple paprika, salt and pepper. That's all I use to season a steak. We're gonna season that liberally on both sides. Probably could have sprayed the steak with a little Pam or a little of this olive oil cooking spray to make the seasoning stick a little better, but I think we're going to be all right. Now, we're going to take this and we're going to spray. I think I had that turn in the wrong direction. We're going to spray our cooktop, and you can see she's already coming up to heat. Go ahead and put our steaks on.
Kennel.
That's only been about a minute. Listen to that. Bring it a little closer. You can hear that searing already. We're gonna simply put that on. We're gonna put the top on, and we're gonna set it and forget it. We're gonna let those steaks cook for about 5 minutes. We're gonna flip them over, cook for about another 5 minutes, and then I'm gonna show you that trick that I told you about taking it off the direct heat. We'll be right back in about 5 minutes. All right, family, been about 5 minutes. There they are. The only thing about the George Foreman grill, indoor, outdoor grill, they do have grills that are smokeless, and the George Foreman indoor, outdoor grill is not smokeless. Oh yeah. Press that down just a little bit to flatten it back out. These are going to be juicy. Ow. Alright, don't do that. I touched that hot surface with my finger. And I'm going to have a George Foreman injury. Alright, we're going to put the lid back on. We're going to let them stay on that side for about 5 minutes. Another 5 minutes. Then I'm going to show y'all that trick to take it off the direct heat. We'll probably cook it up like that for about another 2 minutes, and it'll be time for mama to eat. All right, fam, it's been about 5 minutes. As promised, I'm gonna show you that little trick to get your steak off of direct heat. If you have a small grill or something that you cannot control the direct heat, put your onion. Take your onion and cut it in about a quarter inch. Put your steak on the onion. It's gonna take it off the direct heat, and it's gonna give you a little bit of that onion flavor in your steak. So that's just a little trick. On the George Foreman, I could have turned it down to 3 or 2 and let it finish cooking, but that's just a little trick I want to show y'all if you want to get your steak or whatever kind of meat you're cooking off of direct heat. So we're gonna let it cook on that onion for about 2 minutes. We're gonna pull it off, we're gonna plate it, and me and mama gonna get busy. Y'all stay tuned, we'll be right back. All right, fam, time for the final fry. Boom, there they are. That looks tender. Go ahead and cut the grill off. Oh, don't they look good? Oh, yeah. Now let's go ahead and cut the grill off. Take these onions off. I love onions. I think, Mama, you like yours, you don't like yours cooked, huh?
No, I like raw. But they look good and they smell good.
We're gonna see what we're working with.
All right.
2 for me, 1 for you.
Thank you, Daddy.
All right, fam. There you have it, the George Foreman Indoor-Outdoor Grill. Easy to put together, simple, easy cleanup. Now, I'm gonna show y'all the cleanup when we're done eating our steaks. These things are dishwashable and they're easy to clean. So we're gonna go ahead and shut this down for now. Me and Mama gonna eat the steaks and y'all stay tuned for the cleanup. Be right back.